Dry brushing is a technique that allows you to quickly and effectively highlight your miniatures, and is done by loading up your brush with a small amount of paint and then wiping most of that paint away, leaving only a small amount of almost dry paint left in your brush. Then when you draw this back and forth across the texture of your miniature, that paint is left on the raised areas, giving you the highlight. In this video, we're going to show you how to do this technique using two different miniatures. I have here a Skeleton Warrior, and I've also got an Ultramarines Intercessor as well. And to do this technique, what you should do is first of all make sure you base coat and shade your miniature, which is the case of both these models. And then we're going to use dry paint to do this, which is a paint kind specifically designed for this technique. Now I'm going to be using Tyrant Skull first of all, because we're going to start out by dry brushing the bones on a Skeleton Warrior. And the brush I'm going to use is a small dry brush, and it is important for this technique that you use the dry brushes, and this is why. The bristles on them are specifically designed for it, because they've got a lot of spring to them and they're quite robust as well, which you really need with this technique. And to do it, what we need to do is start out by loading our brush with just a little bit of this paint, and then get some of this tissue and use it to work that paint into the bristles like this, and to wipe away the excess. And before you apply it to your miniature, your brush should look something like this. You see, there really isn't much paint there at all. And to do it, all we've got to do is start brushing it back and forth across the texture, and you'll see straight away, you see the colour catching the raised areas, for example on the skull just here, giving you a really nice highlight really quickly and easily. Now something to watch out for when you're doing this technique is the angle that you brush the model with, and what you want to do is try and make it so that the bristles aren't falling into recessed details. For example, the ribs just here, if I go this way the bristles fall into those details, whereas if I go like that they don't have time to. So always make sure you're angling yourself so that the bristles don't fall into those details. I finished dry brushing the bones of the skeleton, and you can see it's given it a really nice highlight. And it's not just highly textured surfaces like a skeleton here that the technique is good for, you can also do it on smoother surfaces too, for example on Space Marine Power Armour. So we're now going to do some dry brushing on the Ultramarines Intercessor to show you how to do it, and once again we're going to be using a small dry brush. The colour this time though is Kronos Blue, and the key difference here for a smooth surface is that you've got to slowly build up the colour to get that nice smooth highlight appearing. So the main way to do this is to make sure that you only have a very small amount of paint on your brush as you do it, so even less than before. Now like before, I'm going to use the tissue to work the paint into the bristles like that, but this time I'm really going to make sure I've got rid of almost all of that paint before I start applying it to the miniature. Because now, as I start to apply it, you can see slowly the colour will build up. So I'm going to look at this shoulder plate just here. I want that highlight just across the top of that curve there. So I'm just going to very slowly start applying it like this until a small amount of that colour starts to build up. And the more I do this, the stronger that colour is going to get. And there we go. Now you can also do this on power armour on those sharper edges if you angle your brush to go across that edge. So remember, like with the ribs, I've got that edge running around that vent on top of the helmet. So what I'm going to do is just work the brush around like this, so I'm always catching that sharper edge. But also, I'm going to be softly building up that smooth highlight on the brow around there as well. I finished dry brushing the blue of the power armour, and you can see I've got some nice smooth highlights on the curved surfaces, but also some really nice sharp highlights on those sharper edges as well. So there you go, that's how you do dry brushing, but there are a few key things to remember about this technique. The first is that you must make sure you use the correct brushes for it, so the dry brushes, because these brushes are nice and robust and have got a lot of spring in the bristles. Also, you must make sure to use some tissue to remove loads of the paint, in fact almost all of it, before you start applying it to the miniature, and slowly build up that highlight, slowly adding more paint until you're happy with it. But really, that's all you need to know, so have fun using this technique, and we'll see you all again soon.